you can't lose hope going through any cancer journey, really. I really like to share my story and hope that maybe somebody who's just starting their journey can find some strength in mine. Hi, my name is Irasema Chavez. I live in Glendora, California with my wife and children. In 2015, I was diagnosed with stomach cancer. I was having a lot of indigestion issues. I had lost a lot of weight and I was really masking all of my symptoms with over-the-counter medication. I was really not listening to my body. My wife was not happy with how much pain I was having. The gastroenterologist just said, I would like to do an endoscopy and see what's going on. When my biopsies came back, they were positive for stomach cancer. We felt like we were just hit by a train. I was 34, you know, my daughter was 13. Our son was 4 at the time. We didn't really know what to expect or how to anticipate or how to navigate the journey. I was very fortunate. My gastroenterologist, he had already called a surgeon to get me a consultation. I had an amazing team of doctors. I had a partial gastrectomy, so I had 80% of my stomach removed. My stomach was staged at 2B. There was some lymph node involvement. I did 3 rounds of chemotherapy. I did 25 rounds of radiation. Life after a partial gastrectomy was very challenging. I was learning how to reintroduce food into my system. So after being no evidence of disease for 8 months, my biopsies had come back and they were in fact malignant again. So I was in a month and a half later for a total gastrectomy, which means I had my entire stomach removed. After being in ED for 3.5 years, I was diagnosed with cancer in my right breast, invasive ductal carcinoma. I felt like cancer had taken so much of my life already, and here we are again, taking more away from me. A double mastectomy was the right choice for me. I had to do 12 rounds of chemotherapy. I did 30 rounds of radiation. I was HER2 positive, and I did 1 year of targeted treatment. I am doing really, really well right now. No evidence of disease for my breast cancer. Just about 8 years on my stomach cancer. I do live a very healthy lifestyle and can eat just about everything and anything in moderation. I learned very early on how fortunate I was to be diagnosed at an early stage. I knew that my voice mattered and advocacy kind of became a passion for me. If I had the opportunity to speak to legislators and Congress, it would be about having better screening protocols in the stomach cancer space because we don't have any. Or being diagnosed in our 30s, 40s. The only way cancer can be detected is through an endoscopy. Most patients find their cancer stage 4. Their prognosis is not very good. I think we need to talk about really the social economics of it as well. You know, we have people who unfortunately don't have access of care to some of the same teams. I'm fortunate I have a lot of different options in terms of institutions that I can get to doctors who specialize in this rare disease. There are some scary parts to this journey, but living without a stomach is completely possible. it's really hard, but you can live a good, healthy life. So I'm here living.